Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, and I host the Valder Beebe Show on FM radio and internet television. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, which I conduct by cell phone, in studio, or satellite media tours. Go to ValderBeebeShow.com, YouTube.com/ValderBeebeShow, or our partnership network with Business in the Black, which is BlackSuccessAcademy.com. And click on the Valder Beebe Show channel. I'll see you there.
Thank you so much for joining us today here in Dallas, Texas on the Valder Beebe Show. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing great.
Doing well, thank you.
All right. Dr. Luis DeGama and Lori Hernandez Almana, they are joining us today to talk about blood cancers, cures, gateway to cures. If we could start with you, doctor, if you'll set the medical platform for us.
Certainly. So the blood cancers, leukemia, lymphoma, multiple myeloma, these are cancers that occur in the blood and bone marrow. They affect blood cells like white blood cells. While they're relatively rare, they still affect over 1.2 million Americans right now.
Okay, that's a lot of people to call it rare.
Well, it is a lot of people. And one of the challenges is these diseases tend to occur in an older population. So, Valder, I guess the good news is we're all living longer, but as we live longer, the likelihood of getting a blood cancer increases. And that's why the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is so focused on finding cures for these cancers and making sure patients have access to the life-saving treatments they need.
Okay. Doctor, you're the president and the chief executive officer of LLS. Do we have any new cures or new findings on the horizon?
You know, we've just wrapped up the American Society of Clinical Oncology meeting. This is the world's largest cancer meeting. It brings together 40,000 scientists and physicians from all around the world to look at the latest data from clinical trials advancing new treatments. And the answer to your question is yes, yes, yes. There are new treatments on the horizon. The two that I'm really excited about, one is called immunotherapy, where we use the patient's own immune system to find and attack and eliminate the cancer. And while we pioneered immunotherapy in the blood cancers, it's now being applied to many other forms of cancer. I think the second thing I'm really excited about, and it was emerging data from the ASCO meeting, is the fact that a single drug that targets a single gene might be useful in treating multiple forms of cancer, no matter where they occur in the body. Lots of exciting news.
Okay, I'm going to move to Loriana. Loriana, you are, tell us your story as a survivor.
Well, I'm broken and alive, and I'm grateful to be here, and I'm grateful to the Leukemia Lymphoma Society for all the work that they're doing. I actually worked in the Dallas market. I was a news anchor for 20 years, and among those 20 years, I spent three in Dallas on the air doing the mornings. And I covered medical stories along the way, too. That was my franchise, health and fitness. So I was in awe. I was the clean-eating, green-drinking yoga enthusiast and never thought in a million years that leukemia and cancer would become my story. And that's really the message I want to get out to everyone, is that my story could be your story. I was hospitalized for an entire year, separated from my then 2-year-old son with acute myeloid leukemia. And they said, well, this is all we have. The treatment hasn't changed in 40 years. You know, you put your reporter hat on, you're like, how is that? We cover breakthroughs every day for so many different diseases. This is not enough. This is not good. And while in the hospital, I did live reports for my station, then from in Texas at Austin, to explain to be very transparent with what I was going through and why funding was needed through LLS for the work that they're doing, because we're just on the cusp of something happening. And I thought, this cannot be my then 2-year-old son. I want to be reunited with him, and I want to watch him grow up. He needs a mom. And this story is much bigger than me. There's so many other people that are struggling And in that time frame, during that 1 year battle, I lost a lot of friends on the hall because the survival rates are low. So we need more people to survive, and those who do survive have a better quality of life. I have depression, PTSD for all the people I lost, for the separation from my son, for the health complications I have now, because chemo is so antiquated. We need help. We need this Beat AML initiative so we can have some change.
And from what I've heard, chemo is brutal also, too.
It is.
Oriana, I'm glad you're here to tell your story. Doctor, is her story kind of almost regular? And what I mean by that, she was healthy.
Yes, Valder. You know, we don't know what causes the blood cancers. And frankly, there's no early detection either. There's no mammogram for leukemia or PSA test for multiple myeloma. Patients have rather vague symptoms. They feel healthy. They may have a bruise or a fever, or they're not sleeping well at night. And suddenly they find themselves diagnosed with one of the blood cancers. So this is why it's so important to be able to continue to fund the research to be sure that we have effective treatments so that when a patient like Loriana goes to their physician can turn back and say, I've got a treatment that's going to work for you.
And right now I'm always waiting, praying that the shoe doesn't drop, because they say you're in remission and right now there's really no cure. And I have a five-year-old saying, Mommy, are you going to be okay? He's always worried that the cancer is going to come back and they're going to take him away from me. And I want to one day be able to look at my son and say, you have me I'm going to watch you grow up. And I really think that through LLS's mission, that one day we'll be able to say that someday is today.
And you've lost a year of his life also. Can I ask you, Loriana, would you give my listening audience a message of hope because they may have a loved one or themselves suffering with this?
Well, first and foremost, I would say that my story could be your story. So even if you don't have cancer right now, this is a good time to take a look and donate to the Leukemia Lymphoma Society, because this could be you. I never thought it would happen to me. But if you are diagnosed, this is the first place I feel you should turn, because I was in shock and awe. And the minute I called them, within 36 hours, I was sent to Johns Hopkins, and I had, in 36 hours, I had chemo running through my veins. If you're fit, you have to be fit to fight. And that's the other thing, because the chemo is so toxic and so damaging to the body that if you're not fit enough, they have to cut your dose in half. So we need people to get fit, and we need a cure. And at least right now, we need some breakthrough therapies.
That's a great prescription, Loriana. Thank you so much. Doctor, I'm going to wrap up with you. From the American Society of Clinical Oncology annual meeting, what was the best thing that came out of the meeting, and where can my audience find out more information?
I'll tell you what I'm excited about, Valder. It's the ability to use more than one drug together to treat cancer. Over the years, we've learned to fight bacterial infections by combining drugs. And we're gonna learn from that cocktails of drugs, combinations of drugs, is the best way to fight cancer as well. We saw it in action at in the reports from the meeting, and you're going to see more and more of that. I think the best place people can go for information is the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society website. It's lls.org. Or if they're a patient and need help right now, call us. Call our 800 number at 800-955-4572.
Dr. Lewis and Loriana, thank you so much, and please apologize to your producers. I kept you too long, but this is such an important topic. Thank you very much.
We thank you for keeping us too long. It's never too long. We could talk about Leukemia and Lymphoma Society all day long.
Thank you, Valder.
You guys.
Thank you.
And I wish you the best, Loriana.
Thank you.